Yup, I changed it. What you gonna do about it?
Esquire Prime writes, was there ever a toy line that you wanted to get into, but passed completely on because you knew you'd never come out of it?
Not really. I always just kind of collected what I wanted to. Pretty much every toy line has a clunker or two where you're just not feeling it. I am kind of baffled by the people that say, well, I only collect 6-inch figures, or I only collect 3¾-inch figures. I guess maybe I'm just jealous because they have some self-control when I just go out and buy pretty much anything that I think looks cool. I guess I do kind of think that Funko Pops can kind of feel like that, at least for some collectors, from what I've seen on some of the collectors' forums. I am still pretty fond of the Pops, but I think that I may kind of be over-collecting them. I say that now knowing full well that they could announce something that just makes me go,
shut up and take my money!
The only Pop that I currently have on pre-order is their 10-inch Trapjaw, and that's because I have loved Trapjaw since I first saw him in the toy aisles as a kid. He is hands down not only one of my favorite Masters of the Universe characters, but just one of my favorite characters from any franchise, like, ever.
From Superfluous 74, current music thoughts? Who do you think is great, and who do you think is overrated? Is there a current top 40 album you'd recommend someone picking up and giving a listen?
Overrated? I'm not sure about that. I'm not sure I'm qualified to comment on that. The only thing that really comes to mind right now, and it's really only because I saw that they have a new album out, is Maroon 5. I never really got Maroon 5. There was about a month during the pandemic where I really got into Pink, which is not new. I've always liked her since the first album. I am guilty, like many of us, as we get older, just sticking to the same music I've listened to since my teens or early 20s. I do listen to music a lot when I'm writing or creating visuals for these here videos. I have been checking out a lot of new stuff while we've been under lockdown. Well, new may be a relative term, because I find a lot of times, then when I go look into it, it's like, oh, well, this came out in 2012? Interesting. Mammoth WVH. This is Eddie Van Halen's son Wolfgang, who just released his first album. I really liked what I heard of it. I'm sure if you ever dug anything his father put out, you could probably get into this. Queen Herbie is a YouTube performer. She also used to be one half of the pop duo Carmen. Well, that's a pretty interesting story in itself. I like her so much that I bought an autographed copy of her recently released first album. Bare Naked Ladies have a new album come out mid-July, so I'm really looking forward to that. There's a band called Kitten who I stumbled across a few years ago. Most of their stuff sounds like a very cool 80s movie soundtrack. Well, their lead singer Chloe is in another pretty awesome all-girl rock group called Nasty Cherry, who were assembled by Charlie XCX, who I also like. There's an entire Netflix series about them and everything. Miley Cyrus. Two of her more recent songs, Nothing Breaks Like a Heart and Midnight Sky, give me a particular feeling that reminds me of when I was very young and listening to the car radio with my mom or dad, and a new song would come on, or a new song to me at least would come on the radio, and I would just be like, what is this? I could probably talk about music for a really long time and still never express my thoughts coherently. So I thought to myself, what if each of these videos had a soundtrack? And then I said, well, you could always make a playlist. So I did. The playlist for this video is linked down below. 13 songs with a running time of about 48 minutes. I tried to throw some stuff in there that you might not have heard of, along with maybe a couple of things where you're like, oh yeah, I remember this. The first song on this playlist is one that I can't get enough of lately, and it's not really new so much as it's a version people have been waiting for about 10 years, which has just finally, officially been made available. Black Sheep by The Clash at Demon Head. second. Is that Lee Larson? Just kidding. I actually think Brie is pretty extraordinary. She's the bee's pajamas, the cat's knees, all the things. There are a bunch of guys here on YouTube that kind of look like me that make video after video about how terrible they think she is. It's like the woman can't even sneeze without one of these assholes making a ferocious 10-minute rant about it. Now that I say that out loud... This just in, while waiting in our trailer between scenes today, Oscar winner Brie Larson sneezed. Eyewitnesses claim that it was adorable. Now, some of these guys were just enraged because apparently Captain Marvel didn't smile enough or something. Others, I know, are pissed off because she said this.
I do not need a 40-year-old white dude to tell me what didn't work for him about A Wrinkle in Time. It wasn't made for him.
I mean, she's not wrong. As a white man, I think we've had a pretty good run. Maybe it's time to let some other people into the club. She didn't say that white men shouldn't review movies at all. She just wants more inclusion. She also mentioned the impact that reviews can have on movies and the people that cherish them. Using her example of A Wrinkle in Time, I haven't seen it yet, but actually I have seen the film now. Thank you, Disney Plus. I thought it was, you know what? It doesn't matter what I thought. I understand that the film was a flop, but I find it odd how many people equate box office numbers with quality. Especially when we've been given so many examples of just the opposite.
Excuse me, but when a movie makes $8 billion, it's not a bad film.
Okay. I saw a lot of movies as a kid, and I treasured them for various periods of time. There was 2 weeks in the fourth grade where all I talked about was Police Academy 2. Some films maybe only stayed with me for a few days, and then of course... There are the ones that have stayed with me for my entire life. There were many Fridays at school where I would be excited about whatever film was coming up that weekend, and inevitably some other kid would come along.
The guy on Good Morning America said this movie was terrible.
Imagine if every review felt like it was shitting on something that you loved. By the way, while I now think that Police Academy 2 was just okay, Part 4 is clearly the best of the franchise.
But her MCU co-stars all hate her. They can't stand her. Look at the interview.
Get the fuck out of here, you whammy wannabe. If you'd pull your head out of your keister, you would see that they're just having a little fun. Perhaps the humor was so dry that you couldn't grasp it with your sweaty, slippery hands. I think Brie is, in a word, if I may bring back a word that I haven't heard in a while, Brie Larson is adorkable.
Would you like to go to lunch sometime?
No. I'd like to go to dinner. Now.
I can do that. I started this coat check without permission anyway.
If you can watch the YouTube videos of her appearances on Craig Ferguson's talk show and not be charmed for even a moment, you are either A, doing it wrong, or 2, broken inside.
Yeah, hell yeah, yeah.
Found the old toilet. That was pretty cool.
No, it is cool. What? Because it's just a ledge at the top of the castle. It's just a ledge with a hole, and you just sit down and it falls. Whatever's happening, it's fallen.
Who lives down there?
That's probably where the dungeon is, I would imagine.
You really think in a medieval way, don't
you? Yeah.
I mean, is it a problem that I want to watch this clip from Avengers Endgame where Captain Marvel meets Peter Parker on a 10-hour loop?
Hey, Peter Parker. You got something for me? Hey, Peter Parker. You got something for me?
Is there a risk that I could possibly turn this into an all Brie Larson channel? I don't No. Oh God, he's talking about Brie Larson again. Planet Breerwagon? Is that something? No. And that'll be a wrap on this edition of Topic Tuesday. Again, kind of short on the topic, so if you want to hear me blabber about something for a few minutes, leave your topics in the comments below. Check out the Patreon page. There's exclusive patron-only material over there. And if you sign up for second or third tier, you get those collectible art prints, as well as access to exclusive blogs and some videos. There are 5, 6, 7 videos up right now that you can only see as a Planet Breerwagon patron.
Thanks for watching!